All right, hey everybody, we're on to chapter 7 now. This is a game changer because pretty much for the last several chapters, we've been dealing in the world of triangles. Now, triangles aren't going away entirely. We're going to look at them with the context of our new shape, but really we need to figure out a whole set of terminology and a whole set of proving things for our new shape, which we're going to deal with now, called circles. Of course, you know what a circle is. It's one of the first shapes you kind of know and learn how to identify as just a little kid. But we're going to talk about exactly what makes a circle in a second. We'll start with by defining a circle, okay? And then we'll keep adding to it. Then what are some related shapes to a circle here? So what we're going into soon is section 7.1, basic terms. And as we can see here from this sweet diagram, this person doing the hammer throw, I think it's called the hammer throw, right? Could be wrong, track and field folks. Obviously circles are everywhere. Circular motion, centripetal motion, other ways we see circle patterns in the world here. So anyways, this person here is throwing this hammer throw by spinning in a circle. This ball here is suspended at the end of this, and this force, right, generated here and sending it out there is sending it in a circular path, okay? So this ball will go in a circle as she goes around, okay? And this might represent a part of a circle called, it's not actually on the circle itself, but it's related to a circle called the center of a circle, okay? Center of a circle. If we're spinning here, and this is a fixed point here, does the length of this ever change? Does the length of this ever change? No, that's the radius. This is the outer end of the radius, okay? So these are all words that will come up in today's lesson, okay? Flipping it around, you'd actually form the circle itself, right? It's just the outline of the circle, okay? What if she releases this? What if she releases this here? What's going to happen to that ball? Well, as soon as she's flipping around, she makes some space here. She's flipping around. She releases it. Okay, she releases it in such a manner that ball is tangent. It goes on a tangent line that is related to the actual circle itself. So the word tangent will come into that. It's a new definition. So buckle in. Let's get started. We have a little notes organizer too. You're welcome to use it if you want to use it. It's right here, section 7.1. Circle terms. I know you have a test on Friday, but hey, we're just learning some vocabulary today. It's basic thing. So use this if it helps you stay organized as you take notes today and you do our section 7.1 lesson. It'll be a good idea to get ahead of things here. So let's get started with it right now. Section 7.1, basic terms. This section is going to establish the definitions that will set the foundation for our work over the next chapters. Okay, really just three chapters left, technically. We really just want you to see some stuff related to circles this year. Know the words, and then, hey, we'll study some cool relationships as well, too, over the coming weeks. Sound good? Okay, why not? All right, anyways, I think what makes section 7.1 go the easiest, rather than me just explaining all that crazy vocabulary I just talked about in the welcome slide right here, is actually for you just to take a second. We don't do this enough, right? But I think we should totally do it and get ahead of things. It just makes kind of following the lesson a little easier is if you do some pre-work, some investigative work right here. So what I would recommend right now is you pause the video, okay? Pause the video for a second and just quickly, right? Take no more than 4 minutes. 4 minutes should be plenty, right? When we do this in class, 4 minutes. And just read the whole section. Okay, read section 7.1 in the textbook. There it is right here. So it's just two pages. It's there and there. But you see here, there are a lot of things that are bolded out. Okay, the bolded out stuff, what we're going to talk about today. Okay, so I know these videos typically are half hour long, 40 minutes long, even longer than that sometimes. So despite how short this is right here, there's still stuff to talk about. There's still stuff to point out so that you understand what all these terms are before we start working with them next week. Okay, so take 4 minutes, go ahead and pause the video. You're just reading that, and maybe you're thinking about pre-filling out a little bit of the notes for today. Okay, so go ahead and pause the video. I'm gonna meet you back here in about 4 minutes. Then we'll go through each definition as a whole class, right? Whole class discussion, really just me talking with you right now in this video, and you'll write each definition in your notes. And you can use the notes organizer if you want. Okay, pause the video. Go ahead. Minutes in video form, so hopefully you're pausing the video. I'm gonna get started in about 10 seconds or so. I know the end is coming soon. And you're rejoining in 9, 8, 6, 5, 3, 2, and 1. And hopefully you read the section so that I can fill you in a little bit more about the words you just got exposed to. And that's really what it's all about. And I hopefully you did that, and hopefully you can just jump in with me in this section here, and you're not just kind of going and trying out the little Google Doc thing that I have for homework. But anyways, so bear with me. Let's go through it together, shall we? Okay, let's do it. Okay, so you read about circles. There we go, circles here. So here, get this in your notes. In a plane, the set of all points that are equidistant from a fixed point, the center, right? The center, okay? So anyways, center, we see the word center there. We might as well put this on here if we have here. So one of the big things to point out is that with a circle, it's in a plane. Here's, we're just writing, really reinforces things here, is that in a plane, this is in a plane, okay? The set of all points, right? You think about what is included in a circle and what's not actually part of a circle. A set of all points that are equidistant from a fixed point. A particular distance that are equidistant from a fixed point. So we're talking about one particular distance. Equidistant from a fixed point. All right, so let's go ahead and draw one in. So a fixed point might be the center, right? Center, we actually haven't really put this down. Center gets defined a little bit down there for us. We have a center. This could be center O or something like that. Your circles like look like O, so sometimes get labeled that point. You have a center point, and then, right, we have some sort of a distance here that's going to be congruent to that same distance all along, right? All these points here that I'm doing out here, out here, out here, out here. If I drew this accurately, because by the ruler posture, I can just duplicate that distance again and again. If I do this in all directions in a plane, right, in a plane, and I connect it, right, connect it, it would look something like this, right? It'd be curved. Oh, that was a terrible looking circle. If I do it, I do it like this here. Let's do it here. That's what I'm trying to go for. Oh, man, no, it's so bad here. This is the circle itself, okay? But if I did it actually perfectly like this, right, our circle is this, right? This is the circle here because these points are all, right, if all these green things represent the same distance from this fixed point here, this is the circle itself, okay? So the circle is just the outline, right? Just the outline itself, okay? Related stuff, too, is that you got to know here is the radius here, okay? So if you have the entire set, right? Everything in that plane that's the same distance away from a given point, you're going to wind up with something that looks like this. Then the thing is, that actual distance itself from the center to any point on the circle is called the radius, okay? So you can write that in your notes. You just put it on there, and we'll be good to go, okay? So radius, it could represent a distance, but it also, wait, here's the other thing to notice here. The radius is the segment. A segment, okay, I'll put segments, and I'll also put here, because we're also going to use this interchangeably with distance, okay, also a distance, okay, it's also a distance from the center to a point on the circle, okay, so it's through this segment, so this is a radius, okay, this is a radius, right, if I drew these radii, all radii within a triangle, sorry, all radii within a circle, it happens every year, I say triangle instead of circle. Right, so he's saying triangle. So that'll happen again this year. Any radius within a given circle is congruent to any other radius in a given circle. And you get that from the definition, right? Definition of circle actually is going to come up in proofs. Okay, definition of circle. If we're going to use definition of circle, what we can prove, right, what this definition allows us to deduce here is that all radii, and then two i's, radii, plural, radiuses, you wouldn't say, because radius is singular, has the S at the end. So in Latin, right, we change it to an I, right? Instead of a US at the end, we change it to an I to make it plural. So all radii within one circle, okay? And here's another thing too. There's just a lot of circles symbolized through this. The circle itself and then a point in the middle. You actually show the center point, which I haven't even defined for you yet. All radii within one circle are congruent. Are congruent. Okay, so that's actually something that'll come up and prove something that we'll have to say, definition of a circle. Well, how do we get there? In a plane, it's the set of all points that are equidistant from a fixed point. So if we know the radii is that actual distance, and we know all the radii, like if we know it's equidistant from the center to the actual circle itself, then we would know that all radii are congruent within a circle. Okay, so we can say definition of a circle in a proof itself. Okay, that's going to become important because, man, this is getting messy. If I have a circle and I want to say, you know, for instance, I have, you know, this is O here, this is A, and this is B here, okay? I can say that, you know what, these, because from the center to the circle itself, to any point in the circle, it's got to be equidistant by definition of a circle. That means that OA has got to be congruent to OB, because that's what equidistant means, okay? So definition of circles allows to say that OA equals OB. All radii within a circle are congruent. Definition of a circle. We'll apply that to there here. And that's helpful because if I wanted to do this here, for instance, I could prove that that's an isosceles triangle, okay? And that might be helpful because this angle would be the same as that angle. And there might be some other things we could say because of, we could use ITC. Okay, so anyway, just getting you thinking a little bit ahead. Just trying to think about things that might come up here, okay? Radius is a segment, also the distance from the center, okay, from the center to the outer end, or to the circle itself, to a point of the circle, okay? To any point of the circle. So you have infinitely many, right, to a point of the circle, you have infinitely many radii within a circle itself. Okay, let's picture I actually drew the circle accurately, right? I would actually have way more radii I could draw in. That's a radii right there. That's a radii right there. That's a radii. They're all congruent, okay, if I drew this perfectly. If we go through, all congruent. Okay, and then, yeah, looks like a little more like a circle if I draw it there. But, you know, hey, drawing's imprecise here. Wow, it's messy. Wow, it's messy. Okay, let's bring it back to the PowerPoint. The PowerPoints are beautiful here. All right, let's check it out here. Radius is segment from center to point of a circle. You already knew that, though. Hey, here's another term, the outer end. Okay, the outer end. Normally, I'm up on the whiteboard, just labeling the stuff, putting it up there, moving on with our lives. But, hey, it's kind of hard for me to do that here. The outer end of a radius is the point on the circle. Okay, so a radius connects the center to its outer ends, okay? Here's the center of the circle, okay? Here's the radius's outer end. The radius's outer end is the end point of the radius. That's actually on the freaking circle itself, right? On the freaking circle itself. So outer end is something that comes up as well, okay? Okay, the point on the circle, that is the end point of the radius. Okay, so if I know distance OA, that's from the center to A, right? A is on the circle, it's at the outer end of this radius, okay? That's the length of the radius, is whatever OA is equal to, whatever OB is equal to, okay? So point on the circle, that is the end point of the radius, okay? So the radius has two endpoints, one's the center, one's actually on the circle, it's called the outer end, okay? All right, let's keep going, guys. I said this was an award-winning lesson. I told that to you on Monday here. Hey, I think it's a pretty good one. You're probably bored out of your minds already, but hey, don't worry about it. We gotta get through it. You gotta try out. I don't know if you've looked at this already, but this will be kind of your homework here. Is this? Usually this is in class practice. This literally has been times. My lesson's like 25 minutes, right, for this particular lesson here. Okay, well, check it out here. Here's another definition. Well, I know that all radii within a given circle are all congruent to one another. How do I know that? Definition of circle, right? This is that's all the points on the circle are equidistant from my fixed point here. So anyways, congruent circles, that might be something that come up. This one circle is congruent to this other circle. Hey, we don't have to worry about triangles where we have to worry about angles, huh? That's nice. Okay. Is this a convex polygon? Is convex polygon? No, the circle is not a polygon because it's curved, right? The result is we define it through all points equidistant from a fixed point, but the result is we end up with this curved figure, right? This curved figure as we did with number one. So anyways, congruent circles are very easy to prove, right? Very easy to prove by definition, okay? Here's a definition here. Congruent circles are circles with the same radii. That's it. It's not like triangles where you need to get certain angles congruent to other angles here, certain sides congruent to other sides here, or, you know, triangles had SSS, three sides here. You don't have freaking sides. You don't have sides on triangles. Circles. I did it again. You just have radii. That's the defining thing. So if you know one circle's radius is congruent to another circle's radius, they're going to be the exact same thing. They're going to be the exact same shape, right? Circles are always the exact same shape. All circles are similar to each other when it comes down to it. So if they have the same radii, they would also have the same scale factor. And if you're similar, have the same scale factor, then that means you are freaking congruent, right? You're congruent as well. So, all right. And then the next definition, this is one of my favorite definitions. Wait for it. These things, oh my God, I love these. I love these. There's so much in design. They're everywhere, and I just keep seeing them. And yeah, guys, I hope you see them too. I hope you see them too. What I'm talking about right now, next one up here, what am I talking about? Read it. Concentric circles. These are concentric circles. Take a look at it. What do these circles have in common? What do you think? These are circles that share what? What do you think all these circles have in common? Okay? circles that share the same center. Okay, so concentric circles. Okay, so these are some of my favorite guys, my friends. These ones here are all concentric, right? Because this is the fixed point on all of these ones. That is the center of all these circles here. Like, look, this radius congruent to that radius. This radius. So this is the set of all points. That's that length, right? That's maybe length A away here. Okay. So this center has a bunch of circles that are concentric that you could potentially draw in. Change the radius. Okay. Change the radius with that as a center. Let's say this is radius B. Radius B. Okay. Radius B. Radius B. Oops. Okay, you wind up with another circle that has it as the center, okay? So it has it at the center. Different radius and same center means they're going to be concentric circles, okay? Circles that share the same center, okay? Because, you know, a center can have, you know, you can have a whole bunch of circles, all from different radii. As long as you have a different radius and you're sharing the same center, you're going to be a concentric circle, okay? So check it out here. This is C, right? Let's say that that's C. This is C. This is C. All these points would form another circle that is concentric. These are examples of three concentric circles. And God, these are beautiful, man. You see these in design, you see them everywhere. I'll give you an example of something that's not a concentric circle, right? So check it out here. If I have a circle, okay, that looks about right. I drew that about right here. There we go. Okay, and then what about this circle? Okay, are those concentric? No, those aren't concentric. So this is the center of, right? We call this like center. So you name circles based on what their center is called. This is circle O. Here you may have to come up with more names because they have a bunch of, they share the same center. They're concentric, okay? This is circle O right here. Where's this circle center? Where's this circle center? So it's right here, okay, right here, right? There's point A, for instance, here. There'd be circle A, circle Oh, okay, and then these are not concentric, okay? Not concentric, okay? Concentric circles, oh man, these are just freaking beautiful. This is less beautiful down here because this is not concentric. There's an example of circles that could easily get confused as being concentric. Let me show you some concentric circles. Not all of these are concentric with one another, but man, we see, where does this come up? So like, why is this so beautiful? This is freaking everywhere. This is everywhere. Let's check it out here. We're looking at different examples. Of concentric circles. Where do we see this? But first of all, what city was this beautiful picture taken? Where was it taken in? What do we think here? We got the MTA down here. That's right, it was taken in San Francisco. Who took this picture? That's right, Mr. Ford. Good old Mr. Ford took this picture. That's right. This was last year, right? I usually get to this lesson in like early February. anyways, right, we get to this lesson. So I was on the phone with my mom. I still remember this. This is great, like great. On the phone with my mom, just one of those moments, walking down Valencia Street in the Mission, just walking out on the phone with my mom. All of a sudden, downpour starts happening. Downpour. I don't know. I go underneath the canopy right in front of like a business or something like that. Something that I think was closed. It was a Friday afternoon. It was a lovely day, except I'm getting covered in the rain. I have a nice conversation with my mom. And I'm talking to her and talking to her. You know, I didn't talk to her that much. We talked for like a good half hour. So it's a long time. But eventually, at some point, I'm like, Mom, hold up. Wait a second. Hold on, I gotta take a picture. It's in front of me right now. It's just gorgeous. It's so beautiful. It's so nice. It was just so nice. So here, this MTA, you can tell this is in San Francisco because it says MTA, it's the SF MTA. You notice here when it's painted red like this, freshly painted like this is here. They'll make it very clear. This is definitely San Francisco logos. I saw some freaking beautiful concentric circles. These were gorgeous. So why does this happen? When does this happen, guys? So I got a little water. I got a little dropper here. Yeah. So this is something called the ripple effect, right? The ripple effect. The ripple effect will form concentric circles. So these are all individual droplets, right? It was raining outside, so we got caught in the rain. It was a big puddle in front of us here. But each time, right, if a droplet of water, right, you're not going to be able to see this too well, but droplet of water, you one droplet of water. Oh, and I saw it. It was so beautiful. I wish I could freeze that and slow that down. Okay, but check it out here. Drop of water. And what happens? Oh, you can't see it. I have to slow it down, guys. I'm sorry that wasn't the best demonstration. But you know what? It bounces and it reverberates a little bit and it sends out all these circles, right? Because it ripples. A ripple happens here. So the ripple effect is a series of concentric circles with the center being where the actual drop happens. And, you know, with the movement of the water, the wave that gets created sends it to the outward here. You can't really see it, but
So anyways, what's my point of this here? Look at this here. This circle here and this circle here, clearly concentric. The center is right there, somewhere around there here. Look at those concentric circles right there. Like the water is hitting the ground and then hitting the puddle right there. And we got that circle. It's the center shared with this freaking circle. Oh, so nice. And then there's the center there. It's just so beautiful. So beautiful. Look at, oh my God, look at all those concentric circles. Guys, I stopped. My mom took a picture and I was like, I almost cried. Like, I was like, this is something else. I'm talking, I don't talk to you that much. A nice conversation. Wow, look at this here. Look at that big circle. Okay. He probably in circles beyond that that are the big cameras. Oh my goodness. So many. So yeah, concentric circles. And then, whoa, what's this? There we go. A little example of the ripple effect. There we go, ripple effect right there. What are all these circles, guys? What are all these circles? Do I do this? And then I make it bigger, change my radius? Oh, they're all concentric. So anyways, this just looks freaking cool. Concentric circles, they're beautiful. They're in design everywhere too. In fact, one of your assignments in the next few days, send me a picture. Do it. Send me a picture, upload it. I'll figure out a way you can send me a picture. One of your assignments in the next few days. I want to see in your day-to-day life, you need to find some concentric circles. Send them my way. I need a picture of a concentric circle. We'll get to that a bit later. All right, we're back on it right now. We got definitions for you right here. Sorry this lesson's going on so long, but it is what it is here. All right, we talked about congruent circles, talked about concentric circles. There we go. Did we talk about center? Okay. Did we actually? All right, well, that's the fixed point at the center of a circle. a fixed point where... Right, it's sort of the opposite, right? The converse sort of what a circle is. This is the fixed point where all points on circle are equidistant to. Something like that. I think that's fine here. You read in the book if you want a more precise definition. But there we go. We have the center right here. Here are some more definitions here. So the question is on this one here: how are lines, like the sort of this slide, is like how are lines related to circles itself, okay? Because you got this idea that you have a radius. That's the one in green right here. There we go. Where, of course, if the circle is just the collection of points that are all equidistant from a fixed point, right, from the center, well, then the question is, how do you go, like, what is that distance? That distance is the radius. How do you connect it? Well, you connect it with a segment, so the radius is the segment connecting the center to the circle itself, okay? And then the question is, well, what about some other lines? What about some other line segments? Okay, here you see more line segments that are related to circles themselves, okay? We have diameter. You should all totally be familiar with that, okay? Diameter, of course, the diameter is twice as long as the radius. You can use that as a formula. Feel free to do that here. Diameter is, technically, let's maybe define what a chord is first before we define what the diameter is first. A chord is this. So this is a chord. A chord is something different. Okay, a chord is different. Well, it's not something different. It's actually the superset that contains diameters, but it contains other things too. A chord is any segment with two points on the circle itself as endpoints of the segment. There we go. So here we have ourselves a chord. Is that the only chord that we have there? No, of course. Here's a point in the circle. Here's a point in the circle. I could draw a chord there. Here's another point in the circle. Here's another point in the circle. I could draw a chord there. Here's a point in the circle. Here's another point in the circle. I could draw a chord there. Okay, so chords could go anywhere around the circle. Chord, right? Any musicians out there, maybe play the guitar. What's a chord? Strumming the guitar. Okay, guitar, picture this, like an acoustic guitar, it has like a circular opening right in the middle, and you have strings, right? Strings going across it here. My guitar in class. I mean, like Mr. Prothro with a guitar in class, okay? A chord kind of seems like kind of like a guitar string, doesn't it? You know, it's lined up, it's in front of it. Anyways, chord, guitar string, that's how we can do it. Hey, your strings here. Chord, okay? Chord, the end points are on the circle. So that being said, diameter would actually be defined in terms of it being a chord. Yes, the diameter is a chord because a diameter has two, its endpoints are both on the freaking circle. There we go here. So if we're going to continue our good definitions, writing definition skills from earlier in the years, we want to define diameters in terms of something we've already defined. We just defined chords. So a diameter is a chord Okay, what is it? It's a chord, and then we want to differentiate it from all other chords. Okay, because remember, a chord here, chord here, chord here, chord there, they're chords. As long as you have two endpoints around the circle, you're a chord. Okay, so a diameter is a chord that also passes through the center. Okay, and we get some formulas. We get some formulas for free with that, okay, for free with that. It's not gonna be told you anywhere else. Okay, diameter, okay, D, okay, radius, R, okay, right, R, we'll just say a radius for R, that's how it would appear in our formulas, right, 2 pi R, remember that one, pi R squared, hopefully remember that was middle school, if not, we'll go over them when we do the area and circumference stuff. Okay, so center D, okay, diameter equals 2 times R, okay, 2 times R. Twice the radius, of course, right? Because the diameter, here's a radius here. Look, we're going from the center to the circle. We're going from the center to the circle. There's a radius. So 2R equals D. There we go. 2R equals D. Or if we're going to do it in terms of what R is equal to, R equals 1/2 D. Okay, R equals 1/2 D. So we can do that for the radius as well. The radius equals a half whatever your diameter is. And then you can figure it out here. It's easy enough here. All right, so there we have here. Hey, there's another definition right there. Another word we got to know, which is called the secant, okay, secant, okay? If you're paying real close attention to me when I started talking about this, I said, hey, well, radius gets us thinking about how line segments might relate to circles. There's some other cool connections beyond just line segments, but also lines, lines themselves. I've shown you all the line segments that we're gonna care about. This is it, chord, line segment. Diameter, line segment, that's also a chord, passed through the center, okay? And another line segment is centered to the circle itself. So it's not connecting two parts of the circle. It's just connecting the circle, centered to the circle. So remember, the center is not part of the circle. It's just the fixed point where all points in the circle are equidistant to it. So of that exact distance, okay? So not distance zero. We're talking about whatever the radius is, okay? So anyway, secant is actually a line, okay? So I haven't talked about lines yet on this slide, but I'm going to do it now. A secant is this. There we go. Okay, there's a secant. So question for you. Can you tell me what a secant is? Can you do it? Let's do it. Let's do it. Hopefully you're on day two of watching. This is a lot to watch in one day, okay? Secant is this. This is a secant. And see, you cannot. What am I talking about there? See, there's a secant. There you go. It's a secant. Check it out here. Secant is a, is it a segment? No, I've drawn a line, okay? A line that does what? Well, it's intersect. The way I did it at least here is a line which intersects a circle in exactly 2 points, okay? Exactly 2 points. Get it written down, write it down right here. It should be appearing in your notes. Definition of secant is a line that intersects a circle in 2 points, okay? You wanna abbreviate circle, okay? You can do this here to save yourself some writing. Circle, there we go. Just show the center and symbolically show what a circle is right there. That's how you abbreviate circle. And that'll appear in your little homework thing here too. Okay, so a center, secant's the line which intersects a circle in exactly 2 points. Perfectly. So is that the only way you think a line could intersect a circle? It's gotta hit it in 2 points. Think about this for a second. Think about it. That's another word I told you earlier. And whoa, there it is. Well, tangent. Tangent. We've seen that in geometry already, right? We saw that in the trig units. Okay, tangents had to do with triangles. It's got to do with triangles. Well, there is kind of actually a connection with triangles that's like pretty advanced to really understand. I probably won't talk about it this year. So no, but here's what a tangent is. Okay, so tangent, what's the difference about a tangent? So tangent's up here, secant's down there. Here's where I would just sketch this whole diagram out, guys. Do it. Okay, you have it all out here. Ah, no, that was terrible. Terrible. You don't want this. You want that. Okay, I want that right there. There's my tangent. Guys, it takes 2 seconds to do. There we go. Here's my secant. Okay. Oh, actually, part of a secant right here is a chord. So sure, right? Secant contains a chord, right? The segments, because the segments are parts of lines. There's our chord. Okay, radius. And hey, diameter, right? And this is also, diameter is also a chord. So anyways, just sketch them like out like that, and you got it all. Okay, tangent's what? Tangent is a line that does what? Intersects a circle in exactly 1 point. And there would be some neat connections here. Neat connections here. For instance, here, just a little bit heads up on this. What if you drew a radius to that tangent? What do you notice? What do you notice here? I didn't draw it perfectly. What do you notice here? Ooh, that's interesting. There's some interesting things. What did I tell you when the lady was spinning? The lady was spinning. that hammer throw and then released it. Where does it go? Where does it go? Where does it go compared to the center of the circle? If she's the center and she releases it right here, right? Where is it going to go with respect to the center? There's a little physics application of this here, too. So tangent's a line which intersects a circle in exactly one point. Continuing onward here. Ooh, ooh, this is interesting here. Use of tangents in real world problems slash real life. Well, here is a satellite. We didn't define tangents for spheres, right? I didn't define it for you. I defined it for you in terms of circles, okay? But you could easily change that to spheres. A lot of stuff will get applied to spheres. I didn't even define freaking spheres for you yet. We're going to get to that. Guys, there's plenty more good stuff to look at here, right? Tangents a line that intersects exactly one point on a circle. Okay, so what would it be for a sphere? A line which intersects exactly one point of the sphere. So in terms of satellites, right, which is where we feed information to all the time, it beams back information to us. It could be a TV satellite, could be a radio satellite, could be an internet satellite, right? Those are super coming up here in remote parts of the world that have trouble getting internet. The coverage of that satellite could be defined by the tangent lines here. So here, it's hard to draw tangents going to spheres. It just looks weird, but a tangent would definitely be up here, maybe in Canada, as we can kind of see. So here you can imagine a line which would just like touch, right? A tangent just barely touches it, skims one point, and that's it. And then it would continue going out there into the universe, right? Into the universe here. So a tangents within satellites define the range, the amount of coverage it could have. This is a really high up one. It can get to a lot, but can this satellite communicate with over here? Could it communicate with Asia? No, not right now. Okay, we got to wait for the world to turn a little bit, or satellites maybe dedicated some other way. It's orbiting the Earth as well. So anyway, just figured I'd show this to you visually, one connection with tangents, right? We want to use this word as much as we can so we know what everybody's talking about here, okay? So here we got some satellites here. And as you can see here, they're kind of trying to sketch and try to show you what all these tangents, how they define how this satellite can communicate us back here at Earth and how we can beam stuff up to that satellite here. This is the range of coverage here. Okay, what do we notice about all these tangents here? This is kind of interesting here too. From the satellite, these tangents go down here. If we get the collection of all tangents from this fixed point outside the sphere, what does it form actually on the Earth itself? What is that here? It looks like a circle. So interesting here. All these different connections we can get to potentially later. Okay, I forgot about this one here, but this is another random one involving shapes. Circle terms today, guys. Stay with me. You're almost there, right? We only have a few, right? Few things to define left. Inscribed polygons, sphere, and then, you know, we've heard this stuff already here. So inscribed polygon is really the last one that you probably don't know here, okay? Inscribed polygon. Inscribed, okay, and I have here, I have stuff bolded on purpose here. If chords, okay, so inscribed polygons have to do with chords, okay, chords here. What do we know about chords? Chords connect two points of a circle. So here are a bunch of chords connected. Here are a bunch of chords. Sure, a diameter is a chord. Why not? Because it's a segment that contains whose two endpoints are on the circle itself. It's fine. It happens to pass through the center, which makes it a diameter, but it's a special kind of chord. Anyways, if chords are connected within a circle and a polygon is formed, the figure is called an inscribed polygon. Why is in bolded there? Okay. In means in. You know what that is? Inside. Okay. So an inscribed polygon is inside of a circle. Okay. Inside of a circle. And it's inscribed because every one of its angles, the vertex of each angle, okay, vertex of each angle is on the circle and it's inside the circle. Okay, it's inside the circle. That's what it's going to take here. So I don't know if I define it more on the next slide. I don't really here. Okay, the figure, there we go. It's actually defined here. If chords are connected within, so that's sort of a consequence of it, is that the vertex is going to always going to be, every vertex is going to be on the circle itself. But within the definition, they don't need to say that because that's adding more words where it's not necessary to actually define it. So here, write down the way it's defined here. Okay. It's a polygon. Formed only by chords of a circle. Hey, we can take that one to the bank, right? We take that one to the bank here. Polygon formed only by chords of the circle, okay? So as a consequence of this, okay, each vertex, Okay, each vertex of the polygon is on the circle, right? Is a part of the circle itself. And the a polygon would be inside the circle, is inside the circle, okay? So these second two things aren't part of the definition because the definition is just this. The polygon forms by only chords of the circle. A consequence of that is your chords. As a consequence of that, you're inside the circle, okay? If also if your chords, your endpoints are all on the circle. So here, with the way it would manifest itself in the actual diagrams you're looking at this, all the vertices of the inscribed polygons on the circle here. You sleeping yet? You sleeping yet? No, I hope not. I hope not. Check this one out. I got a question for you. Let's toss it out there. Are these figures inscribed polygons? Are they? Well, no. This one here on the right side is not made up of chords. They're made up of what? Looks like they're made up of tangent segments, okay? So tangent segments, so this looks tangent, this looks tangent, this looks tangent. That's tangent there, but this is also tangent. Looks like they might be meeting at the same point. Oh, interesting. Or maybe this is kissing off this right here, kissing off there. But anyways, tangents meet the circle only one point. So anyways, this polygon's outside the circle. Pretty clearly, you're not an inscribed polygon because you are outside. You're not inside, my friend, within the circle, right? It's got to be the chord within the circle. This polygon made up of some chords. Look. This side of the polygon, that's a chord of this circle. This is a chord of the circle. But are these chords? No, those are something different. Those are just segments inside the freaking circle. We don't need a special name for that because we're not really going to be talking about those here. Okay, so no, the left doesn't have a vertex on each circle. The right is outside, circumscribed. There we go. All right, check it out here. Definition, circle. Okay, we're back here because, guys, we need to wrap this up. This has been long enough, right? Long enough. Oh, God, man, is there ever so much talking, so many definitions in geometry here, but we got here sphere. Well, you obviously see sphere. A ball is a sphere, but have you ever defined it before? Let's see if we can define it similarly to how we had a definition of circle, right? It said in a plane for circle, in a plane, the set of all points that are equidistant from a fixed point, okay? I don't have a ball with me. I should have had a ball right here. Let's picture this is a sphere. This is not good. I'm a geometry teacher. I gotta have a ball. Okay, what's going to change here from the definition of circle? Okay, picture it, right? Circle's this, but I want the whole thing, right? I want this, but I also want this. I want all this, okay? Not just in a plane. A set of all points that are each equidistant from a fixed point in a plane goes away, okay? What if we didn't have that in a plane part? What is it going to be? It's going to be this, okay? It's going to be a sphere. There we go. It's going to be a sphere. Okay. A sphere is this is if we just drop the in a plane part. Okay. It's a set of all points that are equidistant from a fixed point, the center. Okay. So you're still going to have this, right? If I have myself, my center here. So in space, you might want to put that in your definition. You don't need the in space part. That's kind of redundant. Okay. We needed the in the plane part for the circle because you got to have a center and you got to find all those points that are the same distance away on the sheet of paper. You remove that sheet of paper, you give it three dimensions, okay? So now all of a sudden, it's not just on the paper, it's 5 centimeters in front, 5 centimeters this way, 5 centimeters behind, 5 centimeters this way. What would it get formed would be a ball, right? Would be a ball, okay? So in space, it's the set of all points that are equidistant from a fixed point, the center. So here we have the center point C. It's hard to draw spheres. You'll see this in the problem set today. It's hard to draw spheres. So anyways, they would have a center point, but they're more than just circles because they're not actually circles. They're just made up of circles, sure. But this point C, if we're talking about the Earth, the center of the Earth here, it would have a radius that would go anywhere on the surface of Earth, okay? So it would come towards us. It would go away from us. It would go to this side, this side. And that's why we end up, we live on this ball, this rock here, and we'll have a radius. Okay, so here are some examples of radius. The radius is a segment from the center to a point of the sphere, okay, to the point of the sphere here. So let's check it out here. These are all radiuses, best I can draw it. So this one's kind of going behind us. I wish we could see actually what continents there are here so we actually have perspective. But here's a radius. Here's a radius. Here's a radius. Here's a radius. You're done with radiuses? I think we're done with radiuses here, okay? So let's check out some more. Yeah, I wasn't done with radius. There was another one that came up. Check it out. Another radius here, okay? So these are all radii from the center to the actual ball itself, right, to it. It's just all the points equidistant from a fixed point in all dimensions, okay, or at least the three dimensions that we study here in geometry, would be a sphere itself, okay? Has the same, this is, we're gonna use the word radius the same way, okay? That's gonna be the segment from the center to a point on the sphere itself, okay? So the sphere itself is just the surface of the Earth. So the Earth itself isn't a sphere. The Earth is a sphere. Its surface is a sphere. And then everything contained inside the sphere itself. Okay? So are you part of the sphere? You have to be on the surface of the sphere, okay? Because you're at the outer end of the radius here, okay? Outer end of the radius is a point on the sphere. So hey, here's me. I'm touching down here. I'm touching the outer end of a radius from the center of the Earth to us here. Although I'm like about three floors up like this. I got to go down and kiss the ground afterwards here. I'm happy to be here. I'm happy to be on planet Earth. Hopefully you are too. Okay, and that's the final definition. Make sense? I hope so. Hey, give this one a shot. I spent a long lesson so far. Name two, I'll just do it with you so you can get started with your problem set already. Name two radii, diameter, three chords, and two secants, a sphere. Oh, test yourself right now. Can you do this as well as Mr. Fortin? Let's check it out here. Well, name two radii. Well, that's pretty easy. This must be the center, sphere O. Okay, sphere O. So that means we know that this is the center. We name spheres like we name circles. We name them by their centers. Okay, that gets hard when it's concentric. And spheres can be concentric. You write that in tonight's homework. You write what a definition for concentric spheres, what you think the definition is. Okay, we defined concentric circles, so we'd have to figure out another way to name them. Probably need a second point on the circle. I forget actually how they get named. But here's the center. Center O, so that means that, oh, radius isn't actually drawn in here, but I know T, it looks like T is on the sphere itself. This could be a radius. Okay, that could be a radius here. This could be another radius here. Okay, these can be congruent. These can be congruent. So here, radii, sure. Two radii, we got OT, okay? And we also have OU, sure, because U is on the sphere, okay? All these points look like they're on the sphere the way they wrote it here. It looks like that's point R, looks like that's point S. You know, you gotta use your common sense. Like if they're putting these random letters down, they're talking about whatever these intersections are between these lines and the sphere itself. So it's on the sphere. So there we go, a diameter, okay? Diameter, looks like we have a diameter right here. Because this is connecting, this is a chord that connects two points of the sphere and goes through the center of the sphere. Okay, so you have diameter of a sphere too as well. Okay, you're gonna have all these things, right? So I didn't define, I'm gonna spend time doing that, but you have all the stuff you have for circles, you can have for spheres as well too. Okay, diameter is gonna be RS, okay? Two secants of sphere O here. Well, I have one actually really explicitly drawn. It looks like we have to come up with the answer for the other ones here. So I have the secants, definitely RS I have here. Secants are lines. Remember, they're defined as a line that intersects a circle in at least, exactly two points. So it would be the same thing for the sphere, okay? Does RS intersect the sphere in exactly two points? It does at points R and S. Remember, the interior of the sphere isn't actually technically part of the shape of the sphere because the sphere is just all the points that are equidistant from point O. Of a particular radius here. Okay, so we have RS. Looks like we have to invent another one here. Oh, wait, no, the TU. We could have said line MN. Maybe I'll just do that, line MN. Why not? Okay, because this chord here, do we have to name chord? Oh, we have to name three chords. Oh, my goodness, there's so much here. MN is a chord, but also line MN would be a sphere. Okay, chord, segment, endpoints on the sphere. Secant, line. Don't have endpoints, so just keeps going. Both sides of the sphere intersect the sphere twice. Okay? Does not ask about tangents. That's nice here too, but you definitely have tangents when it comes to spheres. You can just, sure, clip off one point of planet Earth and keep going on into the infinite universe on both sides. Okay, so we got MN, we got RS. Sure, yeah, a diameter can be a chord. Sure, why not? And what else here? Another chord here is TU, as we have here. There we go. And that is that. All right, what do you have to do? Thank you for hanging in there for this lesson. I even got a test on Friday, too. The Ready, Set, Go. We already did it here. You got a test on Friday in Chapter 6. You know, we just need to see this stuff. You know, a month and a half is going to be a lot to kind of like see and kind of guide things where you've done some stuff with circles and area and volume. So that's why we have this here this Wednesday. So knock it out here. This is, I swear to God, this is like a 25-minute lesson. Like I've been observed doing this lesson before. It takes 25 minutes. It took longer this time because here I'm left to my own devices. But anyways, typically what we do in classwork, after we sit, we talk about it for 25 minutes. Then I have people do this in-class practice, okay, which you're doing for homework because it's hard to be in class this year. We're only in class an hour and a half a week. So anyways, answer these questions on Google Classroom. go ahead and submit them afterwards here. You should feel like you're getting almost all these here. If not, ask questions. Totally ask some questions here, okay? Or ask your friends questions. Go to LittleCSF2. Anyways, I think you can get it here, okay? So, anyways, this is your homework for Wednesday night, to have this one DB do Thursday so that you can just spend Thursday studying for your Chapter 6 quiz, okay? Thank you guys for watching. Hopefully this was as fun as for you to watch as it was for me to do. I'm sure it wasn't. But message me if you have any questions. Take care, guys. Have a great rest of your Wednesday.